supposed to be a moment. This supposed to be a moment. This supposed to be a moment. What good is being the one when you the only one that knows it?
Couch and a coffee table, please bestow upon me a W. That's a W, man. I'm proud of you, bro. You ain't have no couches or coffee tables, bro. Your mother's ugly, bitch. Your auntie would let me fuck her in the throat in front of your dad, bro.
Duke has had a storied history with a lot of ups and downs, some fantastic products and some miserable products.
This nigga got a ghillie suit with arrows on, bro. What the fuck? Where do you even get this shit?
Ladies and gentlemen, today we're asking one question. Which 2K
can y'all
is
hear?
The greatest of all time? And we're hunting for answers. Now, I've been playing NBA 2K for over a decade, and when the conversation is usually brought up, three games come to mind. NBA 2K11...
Hold on, bro. Bro, 2K11 is not even in the conversation, my nigga. What 2K do y'all think is the greatest?
NBA 2K16 and NBA 2K19. 18. For all intents and purposes, they were the best overall 2K products.
Best 2K of all time, once again, it's no comparison, NBA 2K16.
This nigga Davis was trash at 16. Nigga, I used to beat the shit out that nigga with randoms. I beat that nigga in 16 probably like 70 times and beat him in like probably like 25 1v1s. That nigga was fucking trash. I don't know how that shit his favorite.
Best simulation experience ever created for any gaming sports. NBA 2K16 had something I think most sports games struggle with.
Nigga swear he was cold, nigga.
Skill gap. In that game, the dribbling, the defense, all took skill to do. Someone who plays 10 hours a day and who has mastered their craft of dribbling is gonna absolutely cook in 21-0 someone who does not play at all.
2K has had some incredible video games.
He sounded like the Swan. That's my son, my nigga. He's talking about overall 2K since he bringing up 11, bro.
Last decade, a joy to play, deep into the night till 5 a.m. with your guys. They've also had some abominations they call AAA video games.
Hey, that nigga Davis done glowed up. Nope, you proud of that little bitch? I'm proud of that little fuck, nigga.
Games that shouldn't have released, that were wildly unfinished, or that came with big ideas and poor execution. But it really depends who you ask, because for reasons I'm going to describe here in this video, everyone has a different answer.
Regardless of who you ask, though, 2K11, 16, and 19 are always top contenders.
19 is fucking garbage. Where did he get this list from, nigga?
So let's talk about him, why those games were so great, what 2K did to fall off, and how they can come back.
I would say the turn for the worst for 2K would have to be...
Yo, this nigga sucks at 2K. What the fuck are you talking about?
When they were just adding way too many things into the game without really understanding what the game really needed and its fundamentals and its core values.
Facts!
When they started adding all this extra stuff to Park, when they were adding all this extra things to, like,
my nigga Lou
didn't actually address some of the core issues and problems of
my okay
team. All the extra things without addressing the core okay problems is where they went wrong. They thought that a lot of the problems that they had could just
genius
be
Lou
over with these other things that they added to the game that was completely unnecessary.
Okay, my nigga Lou talking that shit. Who would have knew? I thought he was just gonna say some bullshit. Nigga look sloppy. Chill. We fuck with Lil. Let him be sloppy, my nigga.
But there's a few different variables that change people's answer. And the first one is what game modes you play. If you're a huge Pro-Am head, you might like 2K17. If you're a huge Park head, you might
smooth like
2K17. My GM, not so much.
The greatest 2K of all time, still 2K16.
Man, the gameplay, the dribbling, the build system, the balance, the actual good affiliations, solid, creativity.
They had like a water park, an amusement park, and like a rivet factory. The soundtrack! Oh my, that's the only 2K I've
ever played. Hate this, nigga.
It also really depends what your first 2K was. If you played 2K16, you think it's the greatest, but you never played 2K11, you're missing context. And two, you tend to have fond memories of your first 2K. Even though 2K10 was the first one I played seriously, I have fond memories. I mean, my memories will lead me to believe it was better than 11, even though we know that to not be the case. It also really depends how many 2Ks you've played. There's a term used to describe this called franchise fatigue. The more you play a certain franchise, the more you get tired of it. So even if they're putting out the same level of output and innovation, you're not as surprised by it anymore. It's not as new to you as the first one you've ever played. And so the more you play, the likelihood that franchise fatigue sets on you significantly higher.
2K would have to go back to the basics. If 2K wants to come back to peak level relevancy, if they want to come back to that fun game that we all fell in love with playing, they're going to have to go back to the basics and fix a lot of core mechanics, bring back this simplistic gameplay that made a lot of people fall in love with it. And then from there, when you are able to establish
that,
then you can continue to add on.
I think he just know how to use his words. I don't think he can actually point out direct things, you know? But there's a skill within that. This is Legend of Dum Dum African.
You know, the sprinkles, but you have to go back to bringing back what actually makes the game matter, which I believe is gameplay.
It also really depends on the equalize for expectations.
I fuck with it, love.
2K10, when they introduced the micro, everybody was excited with the new story mode. Now we're used to it. 2K21 next gen, that's to be expected.
This nigga ain't shot that arrow once.
The same happened. They introduced the park. Now if we don't
get Bowser the park, speaking facts.
Disappointed about. So if you don't equalize for expectations, NBA 2K11 is not going to be the greatest of all time to you.
Well,
it's true. The series has come a long way since NBA 2K11. There's a lot more depth now. There's a lot more to the game between my team and the new and improved Pro-Am that they used to call the crew. They got Play Now Online. They got a park mode.
He ain't going to shoot that bitch.
And the list continues to go on and on. But those who played NBA 2K11 back in the day remember, it was very innovative. And at the time, it had depth.
I think what makes a good 2K game is
nigga not going to shoot that
fun. That's, you know, we play games to have fun. A skills gap. I think it's frustrating for a game that, you know, you want to play a lot to not have a skills gap because then you kind of feel like you're playing for no reason. Oh, and then a motivation to play. Why do I want to keep getting on this game? Am I leveling up? Am I going to unlock something cool at the end? I think those three things are important when it comes to making a good 2K.
And the last variable is how long has been since that 2K release. For whatever reason, people tend to hate the current one.
Okay. I bet you this nigga agent is not going to shoot this bitch this whole video, bro.
But they love it when 3 years pass. And so for whatever reason, games like NBA 2K16 were disliked at the time. Now, they're loved. They're well known as one of the, if not the greatest 2K of all time. But today here in this video, we're getting down to the bottom of it.
My favorite 2K of all time is 2K18. No, it's not. It's 26. Let me just say this. I thought it was well polished. A lot of things you can do in the game. And a lot of innovation, too. It just felt really cohesive.
Davis finally
the
hit
best
puberty.
2K I've ever played is probably still 2K16. It's still probably 2K16. Everything that they provided in that game, I loved it. So I would still say 2K16 is the best one I've ever played. I feel like there was a lot more that was not only in the game, but it was way more polished. My team felt very, very,
very
rounded, and that was a game mode that you could play.
You think he shade that
long.
Shit?
Park was also really fun. It felt like very easy to play, very responsive. It didn't feel like I was being cheated out or anything like that. I mean, I didn't know yet. Pro-Am.
I put together a weighted rankings with four different criteria to determine whether 2K11, 16, or 19 was the greatest 2K of all time. The four criteria include how fun the game was to play, the overall experience of playing the gameplay, and how much depth the game had. First up is experience, and that's the servers. And when you join your friend on your phone, did you join it on the first time? Small quality of life stuff that make the game fun to play.
Low look depressed.
Gameplay is vital. I mean, just ask NBA Live what it looks like to drop a game over and over again with bad gameplay. It's not fun. Which leads us to the next one. Fun. Gameplay can be great, but is it an enjoyable experience and worth playing? And last but not least, depth. Some NBA 2K games just have more depth than others, and that really just comes down to replayability.
How can they come back?
Yeah.
It's actually quite simple. They can't. I'm so serious, too. I'll catch you later.
Regardless of which, NBA 2K was the greatest 2K of all time.
That nigga Davis got no hope.
Next Gen was just not it. It lacked on a lot of criteria, man. Shit, it wasn't really much fun to play. The experience was absolutely atrocious. The gameplay felt bare bones and lackluster. And most importantly, didn't have
the replayability is by far, in my opinion, like the best aspect to what can make a really, really good 2K game.
This should be hilarious,
right? Out of love, or you fall to this like lull of playing 2K over and over and over again, it doesn't feel like new to you, or it doesn't feel like something you want to come back to. So if it's not replayable when they do those small little tweaks, then it can just really ruin the game, because at that point I can just go back to the previous iteration. So replayability to me is what makes a 2K game really good.
Tokyo shit.
There's an interesting paradox I want to bring to your attention. For a video series I was shooting, I had an opportunity to play the entire NBA Baller series.
Why you say that, Harden?
Was stunned at how fun the arcade basketball experience can be. Played the second one, even better. Gameplay was smooth, silky, enjoyable, fast-paced. Then I played the third. They had some big ideas, but the execution was poor. And the third one was a flop, ladies and gentlemen. NBA Street 1 and 2, great time. 3, not so much. It almost seems as though developers try and do a little bit too much, and it ends up bogging the game down with clunky mechanics that make the game unfun to play.
This so
NBA 2K,
shot
I need
that
you to
bitch.
Start removing animations when there's no reason not to. I need you to start adding in animations that make the game
this
fun.
This nigga got a wet, juicy
slow the
chicken
game down,
on an
you make
arrow.
It less fun to play. And beyond all of that, stop introducing new technology to the game that doesn't
yes,
actually
my son,
improve
agent.
It. I heard so much about random physics improvements to the footwork in the game, only to find out that when you actually play it online, none of that really applies. The gameplay still feels sluggish. Bye-bye. Everybody's
yes.
experience on the game is different, and depending on who you
that
ask,
shit dripping.
A game like NBA 2K17 can rank as one of the best or worst 2Ks of all time. Again, the variables do play a very big role. To illustrate this, I decided to ask some content creators in Hank the Tank, Joe Knows, and Troy Dan to put together their tier list of the last decade of 2Ks to see which one they thought was the best, and this is what it looks like. On the left, we got Hank the Tank. In the middle, we got Joe Knows. And on the right-hand side, we got Troy Dan's list. And you can tell there's big differences in the three. I mean, Hank has 2K15s.
Let's have a look-see. So all the shit talking that fucking idiot Joe does, this nigga has 15 as elite. That doesn't even make sense. And then he has 19 and 20. This nigga don't even know shit. This nigga's crazy, bro. This nigga list is horrible, bro. Them niggas is down bad.
16 and 17 at the top because he primarily plays Park. Troy Dan oddly has NBA 2K21 at the...
Troy Dan's trolling. Y'all think Troy Dan trolling? He got next gen at the GOAT? What the fuck? Does he even play that hoe? There's no way.
GOAT tier. I actually couldn't tell if he was.
It's because Joe don't know shit, bro.
It could almost be pretty challenging, you'd argue.
He don't understand. He ain't played them most.
And I was curious. I brought the question to YouTube and asked you guys in the form of a community poll, and y'all had this to say: the best 2K
paid off
with 177,000 votes, which is crazy, by the way. NBA 2K16 won in a pretty decent landslide. At 55%, 2K11 ranking in at 6%, 19 at 11%, other at 20%, and I don't know at 7%. King Superior put up a good point. He said, most people on this list have never even played 11. That's why it doesn't have a lot of votes. And again, depending on whether 2K19 or 11 or 16 was the first 2K you played, the 10th 2K you played, depending on which game modes you played, because of course those vary, and all the other variables, all
your mother rage.
How 2K16 won this in absolute landslide.
I need you to make sure that quality of life improvement, the small stuff that make the overall experience fun.
How much that ghillie suit cost?
Are adjusted. I need you to make sure that games matter and there's ranked modes and good leaderboard systems so that you can grind and you have an incentive to get better and play the game and level up in the leaderboards.
And niggas who consider 2K19 an elite 2K have shit seriously wrong with them, bro. Like dead ass, like Stretch Bigs, that shit was bad, bro. That shit was bad. They love that shit. They love that shit. That shit not even basketball. They don't like basketball, nigga. They like video games.
More importantly, I need better rewards. When I level up my player after a very long time of grinding a mindlessly boring experience,
them niggas
I
dex
need to be rewarded
gods.
With something. Make the experience of grinding fun, make the rewards enjoyable to get, and make the games mean something. That's how you make a good basketball product.
Yes.
I decided to put together a weighted score.
My chamo.
So gameplay and fun get 3x multipliers, and depth and experience get 2x multipliers. So once you input in all of the numbers, you get the weighted score. NBA 2K11 gets a score of 85. That's really good. NBA 2K19 gets a score of 82. That's solid. But what
no.
I think a lot of people are starting to realize as the years go on and was made very apparent even in this weighted scale here is that NBA 2K16 is the greatest 2K of all time with a grand score of 98. It didn't matter whether you played my team or my GM or it could be Pro-Am or Park. You had fond memories of the game. You had a lot of fun. The gameplay
was there. I missed
2K16,
man.
The overall experience just felt whole. For a long time, it was kind of just like a question mark in my head, but to actually have an answer, it feels odd.
And so the objective is pretty simple. If 2K can make the next 2K look a lot more like NBA 2K16, we'd be in a much better place.
Hey, is this shit worth watching? I didn't see this. This shit got over 1 million views. This nigga got this bullshit spreadsheet finessing. What you mean? Hey, y'all think that's the same chicken? Agent would do some shit like that. Y'all wanna watch this? Afro need to go? I don't know, bro.
But hey, hey, here we go again. Yeah. Here we go again. People talking this, but when this hit the fan, everything I'm at made me. Now break it down. Yo, off the top of the dome.